Hello, I'm Dr. Mike Saville, and I'd like to tell you a little bit about the Sensors and Signals Exploitation Lab. Thanks for clicking on this link. First, we are really close to Wright-Patterson Air Force Base, and so as you might guess, much of our work will involve national defense, and therefore most of the graduates go on to work either within the Air Force or within their partnering contractors. We do have a number of students, though, who have gone on to PhD programs at Wright State University, The Ohio State University, and at the University of Oklahoma. And of course, you can imagine there are many other opportunities in the area that aren't related to the defense area or industries, but that's where most of our graduates have gone. So the objects of the lab are focused primarily on imagery at different frequencies. Here you see examples of X-ray. You have an example of millimeter wave. And you have a setup of what we do for the synthetic aperture radar. And our goal has been to develop the overall process for developing the object recognition algorithms. But then I'll show you some additional work that is more related to plasma physics as well and to millimeter wave imaging. So first, let me talk about the attributed scattering centers. Some of our past publications we showed with simulated data on how we could utilize the information we get from synthetic aperture radar image. This is not something that's terribly new, but we've been working on new ways on how we might set up the experiments using non-conventional methods. Here you can see in the picture that this is just a regular room and there's a radar absorbing material behind it as a panel, but the room itself is not what is considered an anechoic chamber. And so if I put the radar in front of put the target on this pedestal in front of the radar, and we rotate the target, then we can collect from all 360 degree aspects, formulate an image, and by using modern signal processing methods, coupled with our knowledge of how the EM wave physics work, then we can form this 2D picture of the 360 degree view of this plane. This is an airborne command post. It's a 144:1 scale model. But here we can see where we have very strong scatterers represented by the red and yellow, and the stems show us the angles at which it was observed. And if I were to take multiple pictures of this, having generated imagery from two different polarization states, then I can form polarimetric images as well. And by grabbing all of that information, we can put that into an object recognition algorithm and then perhaps identify the particular set of measurements as having been from this command post. Now, other areas of interest recently have been with the plasma physics work that's been going on at the Air Force Research Lab. In that case, here I have some pictures that show you what they collect using a laser diagnostic system. So they shine a laser through a vacuum chamber, and here's a metal wire. And when the metal wire is sitting there, you can see it nice and cleanly in this interference pattern. And we have two different wavelengths, so you can see two different types of interference patterns for the same wire. After the wire is exploded with a high electrical current, then you get this expanding volume of plasma, which is formed by the electrons being stripped away from the copper ions. The copper atoms. And so now we have two different regions, but one is observed at wavelength 1 and one at wavelength 2. And our goal then is to observe the plasma properties, the electron density and the atomic density. For that reason, we're using two different wavelengths to get independent observations. Now, that's not a simple process, and we have to do quite a bit of signal processing in order to clean up the raw imagery shown here in the middle. And once we have that, we can then begin to estimate the fringe order. But you see, we have many different time samples. We have observed from 50 nanoseconds to 2400 nanoseconds. And so there's a lot of imagery that has to be processed. So we've been developing automated methods to do that. But once it's done, then we can begin to characterize and observe the copper, or the aluminum in this case, electron and atomic densities versus time. And so now the diagnostics can be gleaned from these raw interferograms in a very efficient manner. And then we've also been exploring how we can utilize a variety of CAD models. And in the application, we're using millimeter wave imaging. So here you see a CAD model generated by one of our industry partners, and they're showing you the human with clothing and some contraband. And as you might expect in an airport scanner, the image analyst would have to identify what is the contraband. So these are very early works, but you can begin to see that we can take their CAD model and generate millimeter wave imagery. There's much more to do and explore as we consider the material properties, the types of efficiency, and the number of images that might be needed for different applications. So the Sensors and Signals Exploitation Lab does all manner of EM exploitation. In this case, radar, the microwave, the millimeter wave. We've explored some X-ray, and even with the optical frequencies with our plasma diagnostics. So I invite you to check out the webpage or email me and talk to me, and I'll be glad to tell you about it. And when the labs are open and available and you're able to come and take a tour, we'll be glad to do that as well. So thank you for listening today.